computer and learn about five generations of computer. The first generation, it is from 1940 to 1956, in which vacuum tubes for circuitry and magnetic drums for memory were used. From 1956 to 1963, the second generation, in which transistors were used. From 1964 to 1971, the third generation, in which integrated circuits were used. In the fourth generation, which is from 1972 to 2010, in which microprocessors were used. From 2010 and beyond, the fifth generation, in which artificial intelligence is being used. Now, the first generation. Computer used vacuum tubes for circuitry and magnetic drums for memory. The first generation computer relied on machine language, the lowest level programming language understood by computer to perform operations. They could only solve one problem at a time, and it could take days or weeks to set up a new problem. Input was based on punch cards and paper tape, and output was displayed on printers. The UNIVAC and ENIAC computers are examples. The second generation, it is from 1956 to 1963. Transistors were used in the second generation of computer. The transistor was invented in 1947. The transistor was far superior to the vacuum tube, allowing computers to become smaller, faster, cheaper, more energy efficient, and more reliable than first generation predecessors. Second generation computer moved cryptic binary machine language to symbolic or assembly languages, which allowed programmers to specify instructions in Word, high-level programming language. The first computer of this generation were developed for the atomic energy industry. The third generation. Transistors were miniaturized and placed on silicon chip called semiconductors, which drastically increased the speed and efficiency of computers. Instead of punch cards and printouts, user interacted with third generation computer through keyboard and monitor and interfaced with an operating system which allowed the device to run many different applications at one time with a central program that monitored the memory. Fourth generation, from 1971 to present. The microprocessors bought the fourth generation of computers, as thousands of integrated circuits were built into a single silicon chip. The Intel 4004 chip, developed in 1971, located all the components of computer, from the central processing unit and memory to input or output controls, on a single chip. In 1981, IBM introduced its first computer for the home user, and in 1984, Apple introduced the Macintosh. The fifth generation, from present to beyond. Fifth generation computing devices based on artificial intelligence are still in development. Though there are some applications, such as voice recognition, that are being used today. Quantum computation and molecular and nanotechnology will radically change the face of computers in year to come. The goal of fifth generation computing is to develop devices that respond to natural language input and are capable of learning self-organization.